Renee, thank God you're home.
Chris, how are you?
I'm great.
Oh, I'm so glad to see you. What are you doing here?
Well, my in-laws are coming, and you know what that means.
Oh my God, not again.
Yeah.
Don't tell me.
Except they're not going to eat my pork roast again. They want Italian. Can you help me?
Honey, no problem. You know, you come to the right place. Whatever you're going to do, let's set up a little menu for them. Okay.
Thank you.
You know what? You came in just at the right time. Because I just put my apron on and I was going to start tonight's dinner.
Oh.
And guess what? I'm starting with a mozzarella and carrozza because my husband loves that. So why don't you start right now by learning at least this appetizer? Would you like to do that?
Oh, are you kidding? Thank
you. Okay,
great,
great. Okay, honey, I already did one piece. So now I'm going to let you do the other, okay?
Okay.
And this is the way it goes. You cut the edges over here. I'm just going to show you how to cut because then you could do that at the house, okay?
Thanks.
Take the brown off, like so.
Okay.
Okay. And make sure that when you do buy this bread, it has to be the flat top and not the round.
Okay.
Okay, good. Now at this point, you got one piece on the bottom, you put the mozzarella in between, and you put the other piece over here.
Okay.
Now what I want you to do is just press down with your hands.
All right.
Okay? And I'm right here. Go ahead.
Okay, and I just washed them actually, so.
Oh, great.
I can
very good.
Press down on
very
your
good. Bread. Just press. Press because the idea is to have the bread and the mozzarella stick together.
Mm.
And actually, this is a wonderful appetizer. It's a Neapolitan appetizer, okay. By the way. Oh my God, the Neapolitans, what a fantastic imagination to have. You know what it's called?
No.
Mozzarella in carrozza. You know what the translation is?
What?
Mozzarella in a carriage.
Excuse me.
It's like, yeah, isn't that cute?
Yeah.
Let's see how this is coming along. Oh, very good. You're doing a very good job. Here, let me give you a quick help. Very good. Now, I want you to put it on this board here with a little flour and press a little bit more.
Okay. Gosh, this is so easy.
Yeah, you know what? The everyday cooking that we do, our Italian families, we do all easy things, especially with the book that I wrote. You know how people, yeah, 30 minutes and under? I mean, please, come on. All right, we're good. Now at this point, just break an egg, add a little salt, when done, just beat it. Like this.
Okay.
And the next step that we're gonna do is we're going to put our triangles, because actually that's what we have formed, our mozzarella triangles.
We put it in
there? I want you to put it into the flour first.
Okay.
Drench it into the flour. We're gonna do a little excess off like this, and we're going to put it into the egg.
Okay.
Little, very, very good, very good. Okay, now I'm gonna take you to the fryer.
Okay.
Okay, now we're going to the fryer. And you can see it's a very easy process. Once you have put it into the flour, and we have done the egg, this is the time that goes into the frying pan. Here we go. We need to pick up the heat a bit here.
Good.
I don't want you to get your hands dirty, so you might as well just watch this one, okay?
Okay,
by me. So the same thing here, in flour. Pat off a bit into the egg. Oh, I'm telling you, I love mozzarella. And you have never had real mozzarella until I have the buffalo mozzarella in Italy. Oh.
Oh.
And especially the part where I come from.
Yes.
Because I'm from the Campania area. That's where they make it. Battipaglio, Sorrento, Napoli, Monte Dragona. This is where they make all that wonderful buffalo mozzarella. I wish we had
it. It's nothing like anything.
Oh,
here,
I wish we had it here in the States. But what are you going to do?
Not extremely hot.
Otherwise, you're going to burn it. The mozzarella is not going to cook on the inside.
Okay.
Let it fry for a while, then we're going to flip it over, fry the other side, and that's all there's to it. And when you serve it, we'll serve it with lemon wedges and some parsley. By the way, why don't you go in the fridge and get a lemon for me? I appreciate that. Thank you.
Sure.
Meanwhile, I'm going to get rid of these. Hey, Chris, you see this? Now is the time to flip these over because they're nice and brown. You see how brown?
Yes.
Beautiful, beautiful. Because at this point, the mozzarella is melting. Oh, these delicious and easy to make. All right, would you cut that lemon for me, please? Since you're here, you might as well make yourself useful because not only that, when you serve it tomorrow night, you're going to be all prepped and ready to go. All right, I can't believe that your in-laws are coming again for dinner.
Oh, I know.
Oh my God, can she eat? I'll tell you what, you better make extra this mozzarella.
Oh,
colossa.
Yeah, that's not going to be enough.
No, because it's so delicious that she's going to eat half of what you're serving.
Not for that group.
That's right, you never have enough food, especially the Italian food, because they love it so. All right, this is done. I shut this off. Wow. You know, it's not time for me to eat dinner yet. But I really could go for one right now. See, the mozzarella is so well melted that it sticks a bit to the tongs.
Oh, that smells wonderful.
Oh, oh boy. They're going to love this, and so will your husband. Now, what's all we have to do, put a little parsley right here in the center and some lemon wedges around. Do you have them?
Here we are.
Okay. Like that. It will look very pretty. And here's the lemon, and you'll serve it with the lemon.
Oh.
All right. And it's ready to be served.
Wow.
Now into the dining room. Ready to eat? Hey. Alegría. That means to be happy. And whenever you eat in good food, you're always happy. Now, I purposely designed this cookbook so you could reproduce these in your own kitchens in 30 minutes or less. My aim was to share with the homemakers how easy it really is to do most of the Italian foods. And not only that, it's easy, but it's also very healthy and very inexpensive, and like, it takes no time at all to do them. Keep in mind, as I do when I cook in the kitchen, and you heard me say this before, love. Love is the most important thing, to me at least, when I cook. Because from that love that comes from my heart, goes straight into the dishes. Believe me, your family's going to taste the difference. Talking about family and love, I would like to leave you with a deep, loving thought. And I'm going to quote a very famous poet, Gesù Carducci. In fact, he was the first poet in Italy at the end of the 1800s that won the Nobel Prize. And this is an expert of this poem. I'm going to say it first in Italian, and then I'm going to translate it in English. It goes like this. Contessa, cos'è la vita? È un sogno fuggente, la breve favola è finita, il vero immortale è l'amore. Countess, what is life? It's a fleeting dream. The short fairy tale has ended. The real immortality is love. Here's to you, and love may be spread throughout the world.